Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Wednesday morning. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with today's look at Canadian stock market trends. Let's start off with some housekeeping. First of all, next week there's going to be a couple of holidays, so we are going to take a couple of days off, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and we'll be back on Thursday to update the charts. It's Canada Day, of course, in Canada, and south of the border it's July 4th. So expecting that the market's going to be very thinly traded next week. Now, last night we had some technical difficulties with our U.S. data supplier. They had problems and we were late delivering. We try to give estimates when we think we're going to get the data. We posted one and then we got bad data and had to send it back, and then finally got good data. And we were able to update the charts. But I apologize for that. I realize that you guys have to sit and wait for the charts, and we're waiting for the data. So we do the best we can. But again, I apologize for the inconvenience. Now, let's start off this morning looking at the U.S. market. And the U.S. market had a huge recovery this morning. When I first got up, the Dow was down about 150 points. And then there was an announcement from the White House about their relationship with China and the trade wars, and that sent the market higher. But the Dow right now is up 7 points. So while it recovered all the losses, there isn't really a lot of new money coming into the market. So the VIX is still on a buy signal. That, of course, is supportive for lower prices. And it has been the Dow leading the market lower. And, of course, the Dow is filled with all of those big multinationals, where the Russell 2000 just generated a sell signal on Monday. Inside day on Tuesday, of course, the Russell 2000, a lot more small mid-cap stocks than the Dow 30. And, of course, those stocks are more localized. They don't have the international exposure. Some of them do, but not all of them don't have the international exposure that those big multinationals do in the Dow 30. Moving over, looking at the Canadian market, you can see the three early warning signals up there at the top of the screen. We tried to poke out above the 2017, early 2018 highs, and did that for a very short period of time. You can see that one bar that's above resistance. And that was a bearish reversal day. And of course, now we've come down. We're on a sell signal on the TSX. We're on a sell signal for the TSX, the Horizon Beta Pro Bull ETF. And we're on a buy signal for the Bear ETF. If energy prices continue to move higher, that may change fairly quickly. Looking at the market by market cap, the TSX 60 is on a sell signal. Came back yesterday inside day with the TSX closing higher on the day. There we've got the mid caps, small caps, and micro caps. Micro caps making a new low for this move. And of course, we're seeing weakness in the mining sector. Looking at currencies, the Canadian dollar has been on a sell signal for a while now. That, of course, can help our exporters, certainly can hurt the importers. There's the US dollar index, second day of a sell signal, nice recovery yesterday back into the channel. Similar situation for the euro on a buy signal on Monday, a pullback on Tuesday. So looking to see if those currencies will continue the trend. Looking at commodity prices, and this is the big thing that we're watching now, is crude oil has come back. You see the big pressure zone there. We've come back over the last couple of days, heading towards 71.88. If we can take out the May high, then 75, 78, 13 come into play. And the market is still using the flypaper channel as support, so that would be a big tell if crude oil broke the flypaper channel at some point. Not expecting it to do that on Wednesday, of course. Natural gas has stalled over the past few days. Of course, you're looking at that nice open gap as a potential target to the upside. We had a bearish reversal day that marked the top for natural gas. Not seeing a lot of pressure to the downside just yet. So there is a good chance, and certainly we're going to see a major heat wave this weekend. That'll, of course, increase demand on natural gas, and that could push the prices higher. Unfortunately, in the mining sector, look at what copper has been doing, and copper is trying to hold down at the May lows, and we're starting to trade below that level. Haven't broken away just yet, but there is a good chance we're going to go down and test the March lows, and if those break, that is a very bad sign. And of course, people look at copper as a global economic barometer, and copper heading lower is not good. A good sign for the economic outlook for the world. And we're certainly nowhere near a potential buy signal on Wednesday. And looking at gold prices, they continue to move lower. We're in a nice downward channel right now. Next target on the weekly chart is 1250 and then 1218.75. You look at a daily chart, you'll see that between those two targets is 1234.38. Looking up on gold, we need to close on Wednesday above 1281.55. I would certainly take that buy signal if it happened, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen on Wednesday. And of course, that upper trend line is going to continue to move lower daily. Looking at sectors, I won't go through all of them today, but you can see the early warning signal for bank stocks. We couldn't break out above the previous high, couldn't get up to test the 343.75 level. We're now sitting on support at 335.94. If that breaks, you can see the next targets to the downside. And of course, we're looking at really a lot of weakness in the U.S. banking sector. It certainly hasn't rolled over to the Canadian stocks, but they are certainly out of favor in the U.S. And we're looking at an inside day yesterday, so today will be a more important day than yesterday. And looking at industrials, we've pulled back a bit off the top of the panic zones there on a sell signal right now. No major breakdown for industrials, but they have certainly been a large part of the recent gains. Now, the energy stocks are starting to move up. You can see the pressure zone down the bottom of the screen. The index is on a buy signal right now, third day of a buy signal, and we're expecting prices to continue to rise here. You can see last time we traded up, we got as high as 212.50 before pulling back, and hopefully we can break through that and head up to 225 this time around. We came down, found support at the 50-day for a while, then broke down to the 100-day, and so the 100-day is a significant area of support. We'll have to watch that next time we head lower, but right now we're looking to continue to move higher. And last up, the marijuana stocks. You can see we've got an early warning signal up there. Got as high on the Horizon Beta Pro ETF up at the 2031 level. You can see back here in early March, we topped out at that level. And so we're finding resistance up there. Bearish reversal day marked the top. And now we're looking to see if we get a sell signal in the ETF on Wednesday. Let's finish off with some of the most actives, and we'll just walk through here very quickly. Aurora Cannabis, we need to close below $9.29 on Wednesday to give us a sell signal. For Canopy Growth, we need to close below $40.59. Looking at Enbridge, a big reversal yesterday after generating a sell signal on Monday, big reversal on Tuesday. Looking at Bombardier, we traded in the channel yesterday, so a close below $5 on Wednesday would give us a sell signal. Then we're looking at Suncor. Suncor is back on a buy signal as of Tuesday's close. And then we're looking at Baytex. No sign of a buy signal here. We need to close on Wednesday above $4.81. And then we've got that open gap to deal with. Looking at Altria, inside day yesterday, we need to close below $11.94 on Wednesday to give us a sell signal. And then looking at Encana, we need to close below $16.22 to give us a sell signal on Wednesday. Then we're looking at First Quantum, and most of the mining stocks look like this. Inside day yesterday, we need to close on Wednesday above $20.95. And then looking at Lundin, new low yesterday, no chance of a buy signal on Wednesday. And the first financial to show up on the most active list is Manulife. Big down day on Monday and saw lower prices on Tuesday. So no joy there. And then BlackBerry. BlackBerry's been down sharply over the last couple of days, made a new low yesterday. And if you look back, you can see that we're trying to hold the lows from early April. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Futures are flat at the moment, and that is a big difference from what we saw earlier this morning. Not sure if we're going to see new buyers come in. Of course, coming up to holidays is usually bullish for the market, and we'll just have to see how things play out. But right now, we're sitting on a lot of sell signals at the moment. Have a great day, and the next time you'll hear my voice is on Sunday, and at that time, we'll take a look at protecting your portfolio.